What simple task should you perform on every presentation to make sure you're not hurting your credibility? The answer to that question will be found in this Daily Dose of Public Speaking Wisdom. Did you notice that the opening panel for this presentation was misspelled? What was your first thought when you noticed that? If you've watched a lot of my videos or a lot of these tips, you may not have thought much about it. You might have thought, well, Mike was just having a bad day. However, if you're new to these tips, you might have had a more negative thought. You may have thought, this guy can't spell. What's the deal? What would be the follow-up thought that you had? I wonder where else this guy isn't good or can't do the job well. Spelling mistakes are one of the most common issues I see in presentations with PowerPoint and handouts. Now, do people consciously think, oh, there's a misspelling, the speaker must be completely wrong about everything else she's saying? I doubt it. However, it does plant a seed of doubt in the minds of people when you put up a slide or you give a handout that has misspelled words. The other day, I had the opportunity to sit in on a presentation for an acquaintance of mine. She had a great talk about listening, great exercises, terrific involvement with the audience. There were 5 different misspellings on her handouts and her PowerPoint. And I told her, you've got to fix these because it will hurt your credibility. People will start to doubt your expertise in other areas if they think, hey, you can't even spell, or at the very least, be more conscious of your presentation and your handouts to make sure that everything is as good as it can be. And this is such an easily preventable problem. Look, I've made mistakes, even on some of these videos. I'm working with somebody now to come in and help me to give me some a second pair of eyes on the videos or handouts or PowerPoint slides that I do. It's always good to have somebody else look at your presentation. Yes, to get feedback on the message and the flow and the delivery, but also for basic spelling errors. Don't always depend on spell check, by the way. Have somebody else look at it because sometimes spell check doesn't understand the context of a sentence or a paragraph, and it may suggest you use spell a word a certain way when it's not correct. So don't hurt your credibility by overlooking something so simple and obvious. Make sure your words are spelled correctly, especially on your PowerPoint slides. Talk with you on our next Daily Dose of Public Speaking Wisdom.